Since the start, we were only dealing with a network that has only one neuron. This simple neuron takes a set of inputs and initializes weights and biases randomly. And in this neuron, some transformation happens that give us vibe red. That's why this is the input of our neuron and this is the output. But the level of complexity a single neuron can handle is terrible. Like in this example, the dots are completely up red, so data is not complex at all. And then if we try to approximate this data with just one neuron, it will be a piece of cake. But if we increase the complexity of data and then try to approximate this, our neuron will do a very poor job. To show you this in reality, I have created the same data as I showed in the animation with NumPy. Then we will create a network that has only one neuron. After training this for 1000 epochs, we can see this red line is completely fitted to our data. So it was easy for the neuron to approximate this. Now what if we increase the complexity of data? For that, I have created slightly harder data than before. Then we will create two neurons to fit on this data, because when I used only one, it wasn't able to train at all. That's why two. Running it for 3000 epochs has given us this fit. Awful. As you can see, it is trying its best to fit on this curvy line, but seems like this level of complexity is beyond two neurons. Then what should we do so neural networks can handle complex data sets? The answer is to stack neurons. Like in the human body, all the neurons are connected to each other and there are more than 86 billion of them, and each is connected to more than 1000 neurons, creating up to 100 trillion connections. That's why they can do very complex tasks like listening and understanding to what I'm saying right now. But if there is only a single neuron, it can barely manage to do even simple tasks like take our neuron. It wasn't able to approximate this simple data. But wait a minute, can't we stack this neuron so they can do handle complex data sets? The answer is yes, we can. Like this neuron, we can create more like it. In our case, I have created 5 neurons, but you can create as much as you want. And all these neurons are together known as a layer. And then we can create more such layers. So now our first layer is layer 1, and then layer 2, layer 3, layer 4. The number of layers and number of neurons in each of them is completely dynamic. You can create as many layers and neurons as you want according to your purpose. But one thing is still missing in this diagram. It is to connect all these neurons. Each neuron from the first layer is connected to each neuron in the next layer. If I only show the first neuron, you can see that this neuron is connected to all 4 neurons in the next layer, and the same goes for all. That's why they make this network-like structure, and since this network is made up of neurons, they are known as neural network. The first layer of this neural network is known as the input layer, because from here the data goes into the network, and the last layer is known as the output layer, because from here we can get predictions made by our model. And all the layers in between them are known as hidden layers. For a neural network to be qualified as deep, it should have 2 or more than 2 hidden layers. In this neural network, there are 2 hidden layers. That's why this is a deep neural network. And all the neurons in this network works on the same summation and activation principle. For this neuron, the output from the first layer neuron is the input for this neuron, and then it performs the summation and activation operation and gives it output. And now this output will work as the input for these neurons. This entire thing happens with all the neurons in the neural network, and everyone is giving their tiny shell to make a working and learning neural network. Talking about training a neural network, it is similar to how a single neuron is trained. We give X and Y as the training data so the network can train itself. It uses X to calculate the vibe red, and then it compares this vibe red with actual Y by using the loss function to calculate the error made by the network. And according to this error, weights and biases are updated using an optimizer. More about optimizer in this video. Then this entire process is repeated again and again till the error is considerably decreased. Now if we try to fit our previous data with a deep neural network, we can easily do that by Keras. This Keras.sequential is a function that accepts a list of layers and then executes it one by one. I have created the first layer with 5 neurons, the second layer with 4 neurons, the third layer with also 4 neurons, and the last layer with 1 neuron. I've applied activation ReLU to all neurons except the last, because in the regression problem we don't apply any activation to the output layer. Then I have simply compiled and fitted it with the above data. After 2000 epochs, it has reached the MSE rate of 8.06, which is too good compared to the previous. By seeing the graph, you can see it has completely approximated this data, but still there are some irregularities in this line. By making a more complex neural network, we can decrease MSE even more. Now our MSE is about 0.5. Too good. This was the benefit of using a deep neural network. You can use a deep neural network for any project from regression to classification. Just ensure that you are using an appropriate number of layers and neurons. Using too little will underfit the data. Using too many neurons will cause it to overfit the data. That's why to choose well. So that's it for today's video. Till next video, see my other videos, and if you are from the very future, I may have already uploaded many videos in this series. So you can get this playlist link in the description and many other useful resources. See you in the next video.